Okay, so I thought the way we might approach this is if we build up the flywheel first. The cage is obviously going to have two flywheels, and we're going to make the flywheel fit the motor. And we'll probably do some nice sort of frills and shit on it. So that's all fine and good. And then we can start to build the cage around the pair of flywheels. So when we get the flywheel set up right, we could probably then have another, like a model of the motor. And then sort of go from there. Anyway, let's begin and we'll see what happens. So let's just create our first profile here. Bear in mind, this is my slow laptop. So what I'm going to do is just put a line here. I'll lock it in place. This could be my rotational datum point. When I measure, so it's a 1.5 millimeter shaft on the motor. So let's come out here and we'll do a 1.7 millimeter gap. The way I'm thinking is that the wheel is going to go bit like this. To here. So that's more or less going to be the profile of the wheel. Let's just make sure. Okay, so it's already constrained. Now that's cool. I think we're going to go for a 3 millimeter high. That seems to be about right. I hope it's right. We'll see when worst case scenario, I can always print off a like a bushing or something like that if I need to make additional height here. So the issue is going to be height around here. And then what we can do is measure the outside of the flywheels, the stock flywheels ideas. It's 13.8. So let's come out here, 13.8. And we said that the radius of the wheel was going to be, so the diameter was 38 millimeters. If we divide that by 2, then we end up with 19 millimeters. Okay, now this here is a bit skew-iff. So what I'm going to do now is measure the motor. So it's 18.4. Now I'm going to add an extra 2, so we're going to make this 18 point, make it an extra point. So that's 18.8. Divide that by 2. Brain's a bit starved at the moment. 18.8 over 2. So it's 9.4. And now remember to the datum point here, 9.4. Okay. All right, so I'm going to lock this one into place so that we have here, this is where the shaft of the motor protrudes through, and it's just going to sit like this. Now the motor itself is going to be a bit bigger. So if we were to take let's get a box. And then I think we said that was 18, so that'd be 9.2. And then we can say this one here to here, 0.2. So this box here represents the half of the motor. Okay, this here represents the flywheel edge. So now I think we were planning on doing a 9.5 millimeter. Okay, and then what we can do is get a cradle point. Okay, and then we also want to create a parallel line to this. So this is the center line datum. Now the design called for one millimeter gap between wheels. So what we can do here is have a 0.5 millimeter gap. So this datum here represents the exact center line of the flywheel cage. And then coming around here, we would expect the other flywheel. So this bad boy, take a drink. What we can do is extend this out. Bring him around. To there. Now this is an interesting thing. So we've got the chamfer here. That's a 1 millimeter on the wheel, and this is a 3 millimeters. So this here represents the chamfer on the flywheel. Oh my goodness, look at the size of this. Okay, now we should probably also add something at 45, so we'll do a small chamfer in here, just a small 1 millimeter chamfer. I think it'll be okay. And we can do some fanciness out here later on. And the good thing with this particular flywheel is that it uses bolts to go through the top. And based on the location of these bolts, Looks like we're only going to be able to use two. That's okay. Means we can have a nice and open sort of flywheel. I think that's probably good enough to begin with. What we can do now is create, so the axis, if you remember, is over here, 360 degrees. New body. This is our flywheel. Now we should probably add a small fillet around here. Okay, now at this point we can give the body a name, we'll call it flywheel 1408-95, and we're going to give it an appearance. Save that. All right, so I'm expecting that the motor should be able to just fit into that, no problems. Now what we need to do is let's come across to Emacs 1408. So it's a 5 millimeter diameter for the screw holes. Okay, so just looking at the schematic here, let's put another sketch down here. So 5. That might be 10 now. So 5 radius. No, I've made a mistake here. That's 5 diameter. I've made a mistake in the previous sketch. Give me 1.7. Give me 1.7 divided by 2. 0.85. Now, because I've got all the positions locked, all it's done is expanded this out a little bit. So you can see 0.85. This is coming. Okay, and then when we put this bad boy up here, Let's just draw a line down. Let's mark those as a coincident. And at this point, we're going to draw a 2 millimeter. 2.2. Okay, that's all we want. Wow. Okay, now next, let's do the, actually, what am I doing on this side? Let's do it on the inside. Let's do the cooling vents. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it's 2.14 millimeters. What I'm going to do is just draw two lines parallel to each other. And then if I make them the same size, that's going to get them so that it's center, self-center. And then 2.14. That's cool. And the other part is 9.25 millimeters circle. 9.25 millimeters. Okay, now what we can do is create a circular pattern. We probably want center point here. Yep, three of those, that's cool. Get these ones, pop them out the other side. Okay. Let's do a chamfer, two distances, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ah, shit. Two distances, 3 millimeters down. Probably about there, I think, is okay. Can I take this one down even more? How far down does this come? That, yeah. That'll work. So this should allow air to be exhausted out. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 10, 11, 12. Just to take the stress riser off. What we can do is just have a small chamfer on the back side of this. Just a equal distance. Not much. Okay, and this is just to provide a little bit more meat on the spoke. And so when we have a look at the motor, there should be, that should just tuck in easy. I think that's going to work. It'll be just fine. Just we'll make a circular pattern. The axis here. It's not going to be quite so easy. We can create a circular pattern. Okay. So this feature. Okay. Yeah, I don't think that's a good idea. We can do now. Let's create a model. So just go straight into the cage. Okay, let's extrude that. In two directions. There should be approximately a millimeter gap between these points. Game minimum distance is a millimeter. The body is. Turn it off. All right, let's look at the deck. The deck will be 18.5 millimeters down. We can construct a 18.5 millimeters down. It's a nice and convenient to look at. So let's just project these circles here. And we can project the outer edges of the flywheel. We can turn off the flywheels. So this is the main point. So we're looking at a let's say 12 millimeter. So these are 12 millimeter circles. Okay, now at that point, what we can do is say 2.2. All right, so let's create a circle pattern. It's the object, center point, and I want four of them. Circular pattern, object, center point, and four. I also want to put a 6 millimeter hole right down the middle. This is for the motor shaft. Okay. Coronary component on here. Sketch. So we can do rectangle here. We'll make that 50 by 60. And then let's make a couple of points here. We're going to make all these the same. And should put the others. We can make it a bit wider than that, I think. This is paying us. Okay. We'll see for a minute. Okay, so I just went out to get a drink and a snack. So part of my munching on some peanuts and stuff like that. Alrighty. So let's just work out where we are here. Here's the top of the flywheel. Now I've got a 4 millimeter thick cage. It's 25.5 millimeters. Now, if I was to get 25.5 on my caliper, so we've still got lots of room. But what we need to get to, so the mounting point, flywheel, cage, to 27 point. So it's about 28 millimeters. So what I need to do is come down another 2.5 millimeters. Wow, so that's a thick cage. Now this here should act. That's the datum point, so that was 26.4. Okay, so that's the front. The rear point is actually a bit less, but the front's the lowest. So let's get the front of the cage sorted out first. Let's create a sketch here. Just get a datum point. This is the distance . It's about 7 millimeters. It's about 18 millimeters. Wow. All Okay, let's bring this dude down here. Okay, that's good. And this is to center this particular structure. Okay. Pause. Put a bit of a structure in here. Okay, so this to here would be 1 millimeter. The thickness is 1.5. Well, I'm inclined to do 2 millimeters because we're printing through this stuff. We're going to make it 8.5 millimeters long. Okay, so we have a 3 millimeter slot in this here. Okay, it's down to 4.19. Okay, now let's think about the barrel. Let's put our foam bead back on. Okay, I have the third barrel. And then 0.5 millimeters. From 4.5 millimeters is the OD. And 4.5. Yep. Now the thing we actually need to only have only have that. So it should be to 18 points. We'll just start adding millimeters. We're at 21.5. Let's take 3.5 off that. It should. Well, it's 3.5. Okay. All right, so and this is the faux barrel. Comes inside here. Fun's coming out there. From here, about 24.5 millimeters from center line. So that's where the tow barrel ends. I think that'll work. Okay, so what we can do is with this line, we can construct plane at an angle, be 90 degrees, and then we can sketch on this, check this again. Just make that 14.5, so that should give plenty of room for the dart to come through. Interesting, they're a little bit past that. Fact. Okay. Okay. Now, if I put a sketch up on here and then come across to here, okay. Finish that sketch and then come in and then just put a plane at an angle 90 degrees. Sketch in there, the foam disappear. Okay, and then what we can do is play. Wrong here. Some plants. It's plenty else. Alright, so what I'm going to do with this is perform a sweep. Just turn the flywheels off. Right. Okay, we probably want to bring mine up that way. Distance to object. Thanks. Distance to object. Okay, so distance. See how we go with this. And then what we can do is create a profile will be. Select okay. Before I do that, let's come back to here. Still another one of those. So I'm going to, how about we do a 20 millimeter hole from here? We do 25 millimeters. Okay. So that. 25 millimeters. Okay. We come back in here. Let's get a round on that. Let's sketch, take the body, see if here's the problem. About Okay. Oh, that'll work. Alright, so I've got a nice shape on that. Okay, last. Work on the back side now. Get these two and make them inside. Demands down. think that's going to be enough for today. What I will do is print out a copy. Just going to print like this. Okay. Thank you very much for watching, guys.